In this video, we will discuss how to calculate d-spacing, which we also call as interplanar spacing, from XRD data using Origin. That an ideal crystal is an infinitely large and perfectly ordered array. From infinite, we means here a few microns, because we are talking with respect to the X-ray wavelength, which is few angstrom. Few microns will be an infinitely large length for X-rays. We see here that atoms are arranged in a crystal in an ordered way. So it depends on the direction of X-rays in which it hits the material. When we consider the powder sample, then the grains will have different orientations and different planes will show reflections to the incident X-rays. If the planes are like this, we represented by the Miller indices HKL, and such a plane we call is 100 plane, and the distance between these two planes we call the interplanar distance, and it will be dHKL, and here we will call it d100. Similarly, if the arrangement of planes or the orientation of plane will be different, then we will have a different plane and different interplanar spacing. For example, if the X-ray hit it from this direction, then this is the HKL, which one we call is 110 plane, and it will have a different interplanar spacing. We use in X-ray diffraction the Bragg's law of diffraction, which is 2d sine theta equal n lambda. Here from d we mean the interplanar spacing, which is dHKL as well. It is this spacing between the planes. While d sine theta is the part difference between the two rays of X-ray. In Bragg's diffraction law, we are having 2d sine theta equal n lambda. Here in this law, n is the diffraction order, which for the first order diffraction we take is equal to 1. Lambda is the X-ray wavelength, which is for copper K alpha is 1.5406 angstrom, and for other sources it will be different, but it is of the order of angstrom. D is the interplanar spacing in angstrom, and theta is the Bragg's angle, which we will have to measure in degrees. When I write dHKL from this equation is equal to lambda over 2 sine theta, then I can find the interplanar spacing from this equation, because I know the wavelength, and the only thing I require from the XRD pattern is the theta value, the Bragg's angle value. So we will have to calculate the position of the peaks or the theta value from our XRD plot. So let's start with the XRD data, and I start origin. This is the LIF XRD data, and let me plot this data here. And here's the data, and I can see that it requires a baseline correction. So I will have to go to analysis, peaks and baseline, and then open dialog. And here I would like to do the baseline correction. So I will select subtract baseline. Next. And here instead of constant, I will go for the user defined, and here it is. It will be a perfect correction. And I go next, next, and I finish this. So here, now the two columns is having the data, which is baseline subtracted. And let me plot this data. And here is the baseline corrected data. Now I will have to find the positions of these peaks which are required. So I will discuss some ways to do this thing. The first way is to take the data reader and find the positions of these peaks. So I will click here, and here it will show me that this value is 38.68. So I can write it down. Similarly, I will do the same practice for rest of the peaks. Another way is that I select the annotator tool, and from the annotator tool, I can now write the values here above the peaks. So I will have to click here first and then click enter. So it will annotate the value, the X and Y value here. I can do shuffle this value. I can rearrange this one very easily. And I will do the same practice for the rest of the peaks as well. So it will annotate all the peaks. And for the ease, I can do reshufflings and I can reorder them. Now there is another way, and that way is also very straightforward. So I will plot the data again and just increase the visibility of it. And now I will just focus on the peaks only. And here, to find the positions of these peaks, I will utilize the fitting technique. So I go to analysis, peaks and baseline and multiple peak pit, and I will open the dialog. I will select Gauss here. And now I will have to double click on the peaks in order to select them. So I select one and then the next. Similarly, the next one. And here it is, and the last two peaks as well. And this is the fourth peak, and this is the fifth one. And I will go to the open NL fit in order to fit these peaks. And here is the menu, which is the nonlinear fit, Gaussian fit. This is one iteration, and this is the fit until converge, means number of iterations will be performed. So I will click this one, and it has fitted the peak, so I will click OK. And now I have these five peaks, so I will go to the data. And here in the nonlinear fit peak 1, we are having the data. So under the option summary, we are having the XC values is the positions of these peaks. I can compare these values with the values that I already found from the data reader or from the annotator tool. So let's open the file, and here is the graph, and we have already annotated the values. So let's compare them with the fitting values. Let me zoom this one, and here they are. So here we are having 38.67 and here 38.68. So it's a correct value. And similarly, this one is 44.98. This is 65.5. So we are having almost the same values here. I will just copy these values and we'll go to the Excel template for calculations. And here is the Excel template. This I will provide with the video. And here in this template, we are having the Bragg's angle 2 theta values, and I will have to paste those values here. Now from these values, I will have to calculate theta. So I will divide that column by 2. And click control enter, and then double click here, so it will calculate all the values. And now here I will find the DHKL. So the lambda value is already over there, which is 1.5406 angstrom divided by 2 sine theta. So let's start with that value first. And this is multiplied by sine. We will have to note here one thing, that Excel by default calculates the value in radian. So we want to calculate this value in degrees. So I will first calculate its radian, and then Excel will calculate the radian of it. So ultimately I will get the value in degrees. So I will have to convert this into radians, and then I will select this is the C3 column, so I will select the C3 here, and finally just putting all the brackets here, and that's it. So I get the value 2.3267 angstrom, because the wavelength is in angstrom, so this value is in angstrom. I will drag for the rest of the values. And here I can see that as different planes are at different angles, so as the angle increases, we are having a constant decrease in the interplanar spacing. Thank you for watching the video.